Good morning. It is good to start a conversation about internet and governance, two things that you don't naturally put together. But if you were to walk into the rotunda of the Capitol, you'd see one of the portraits of our founding histories, which is the signing of the Declaration of Independence. Now, what does that have to do with the internet? The principle, the unifying historical, what we believe is a universal principle, all people are created equal, came from that document. It then became the organizing principle for our government. And as you look through history, and we have different markers that define and tell our story as a people. There are five flags that fly 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, 365 days a year. They never come down, decreed by official action by the Congress or the President. Those flags are one at Fort McHenry, 1812. It's where we get our Star Spangled Banner. And basically, you have Great Britain, the biggest, baddest nation on the earth at the time, telling a young nation, you're going to do it our way. And we say, no, we'll keep our freedom. We'll never take this flag down. It was a defining moment for us. Second flag that flies constantly is at the Capitol. Now, I got to work in the Capitol as a senator, as a Senate staff, and as a member of Congress for almost 20 years. It's a place that I still walk into and have a sense of awe of the history. And when we can make agreement and make progress, another sense of awe. So our governance. The third flag that we have that never comes down is at Arlington. It's at the Tomb of the Unknown Soldier. And if you think about it, Arlington started during the Civil War. So Lincoln says it's a new birth of freedom, and for the first time we're beginning to live up to the ideal of our nation that all are created equal and all are free. The fourth flag is at Pearl Harbor, at the Arizona. Now this is the time where we say as a nation, from being protectionist and isolationist, that we will fight for the freedom of all nations, all places throughout history. Another defining moment. The fifth flag that flies 24 hours a day, never comes down, is on the moon. So it is our moonshot. Great spirit of discovery, the frontier, exploration. And if you look at those flags, they really define and tell the American story and the American character. Our democracy, our equality, our freedom, discovery. Now those founding principles were really at the beginning of the internet. They wanted an open, an equal, and free internet. They wanted to share, to collaborate, solve problems. They didn't want barriers to entry, barriers to innovation, barriers to research. And those principles were unifying. Now we have a chance in the next 2 weeks, and this is where governance comes in, to make a historic victory possible for an open and free internet. The FCC will adopt rules led by Chairman Wheeler of a historic consequence, a chance to plant the flag, protect it, sustain it. Now, if you look at what gave us the internet, there are defining moments where we rejected monopolies and we embraced competition and freedom. So the breakup of AT&T in 1984, which gave us long-distance competition and fiber networks, which became the backbones of the internet and the information age. In 1992, we break cable monopolies, and because of that, they replaced their old analog networks with digital networks, and competition is embraced. It is, you know, kind of the spirit of the movement around the open internet. You can take on the giants. You can level the world. You can have startups and streamers and dreamers. You can win this victory. Founders that we're going to get to hear later, like Tim Berners-Lee, the World Wide Web. We have a chance. We have a chance in the decisions that are before the FCC in 2 weeks to plant a flag on the high ground that unify the principles from the beginning till now that embody the universal and American values of an open and free internet. Those rules, if protected and preserved, will make the next generation have all of the fruits of the prosperity, the equality, the opportunity, the networks that help us build a better country. And so I want to challenge everybody. This is the time to advocate, express, support Tom Wheeler, the chairman of the FCC, and those that will vote for his order in 2 weeks. And if we do, and I believe we will, and that we will taste that victory, we will ensure and protect an open and free internet for the next generation. Thank you very much.
Chip Pickering, thank you for the inspiration and your leadership. I have one question based on your Ignite talk, which is, this is a fascinating topic which defies some of the bipartisanship that we've seen in Washington. And you were on one side of the aisle, and lots of other people have been working on this on the other side of the aisle. What is it about a free and open internet that allows it to have this bipartisan quality? And is there something we can learn from that?
The history of the net neutrality principles and rules started with a Republican commissioner at the FCC. As we went from monopoly policy to competitive policy, it was a bipartisan national consensus. Those commitments of consensus have been strained in the last few years. So part of our challenge is to restore the bipartisan commitment to it, to maintain it going forward, so that these rules and these principles aren't constantly in question either in the courts or in Congress. So the vote in 2 weeks, we hope will begin, I hope, the beginning of the acceptance and the settled law and principle and rule around an open and free internet. We will be from a position of strength once the rules are adopted in 2 weeks. And we should commend Chairman Wheeler for his leadership. And we should encourage all members of Congress, Republican and Democrat alike, to support net neutrality and the open and free internet.
Excellent. Chip Pickering, thank you for your leadership.
Thank you.